I would talk about two different types of common mistakes. The first is the call I get from clients saying that we need a work visa for a certain foreign national, and we need it right away because he's already here. He came in from the Rome office or from the Tokyo office, and he's going to work. As you know, for a foreign national to do work in the United States, that person has to be on some type of qualifying work visa. Now, it quite often happens that whoever is making the decision to transfer this individual to the U.S. Hasn't gone through the work visa process, but just wants them there ASAP to work on a project. So they come in on a business visa or a visa waiver, and they start working. When that comes to light at your company, you'll want to make sure that, as much as you can, that the foreign national actually isn't doing work. You want to limit their activities to only business activity allowed under the B visa or the visa waiver program, and that would be negotiating contracts, taking specifications, planning and work meetings, but not actually rolling up your sleeves and doing work. Or really, in the best case scenario, sending the employee back to the foreign office or foreign country while the work visa process is going forward. And really, to kind of solve this problem, you want to make sure you get to it before it occurs. And when I say that, I mean that you want to educate internally those folks who do international transfers, whether it's HR, whether it's business managers, to make sure that they know that the work visa is required and that an immigration attorney and the immigration team at your company should be brought in well in advance of some type of relocation to make sure that the work visa process is initiated as early as possible so that you're not slowing down their timeline as well. The other big mistake that I see at companies is not following through on the compliance piece. And by that, I mean that once you have the foreign national worker here on an H-1B visa or an L-1B visa, your job is not done. You also have to make sure that all the paperwork and compliance pieces are taken care of after they arrive. And certainly for the H-1B, there are lots of different compliance steps that you have to take, whether it's putting the public access file together in the proper way, or updating the government if there's a material change in the employment and the excuse me employment relationship. So making sure that you drill down and you have programs in place to take care of the post-arrival piece for immigration compliance is something that I think companies can almost always spend a little more time on to make sure they're getting it right.